Students, again welcome to my English class. Dear students, today I would like to go through the evaluation video. Okay, guys. In our previous classes, we learned from integrative sentence. There we discussed only three rules and three structures about that. Today I would like to take the test of you. That means they will go to the evaluation report. Okay, boys. Okay, follow me. And you go to side. Okay. Now I'm writing some example and we will discuss the answer of that. And if you ask the questions, you will try your level best to give the answer of the questions. Okay. Next one. Okay, dear students, at first I would like to make a request that you learned in your previous class. And the question of changing sentence and question in interrogative form, we learned the structures. The first structure I would like that if we find the use of everybody, everyone, anybody, anyone, or if you find any one of these five at the beginning of the sentence, then the particular structure should follow. And in the second thing, we learn that if you find the use of nobody, no one, none, etc., any one of these three words you can find at the beginning of the sentence, then the same structure or second particular structure should be followed there. And also learn three rules. And in three rules we learned that if we don't find a mention of any kind of this eight perspectives, anybody, everybody, anyone, all, nobody, no one, none, these sorts of eight words, this is what we learned from the first rule and second rule. If we find that there is no mention of any kind of word from this age, that it will be words that will come in contact with knowing that everybody and one and to be known, all and nobody in one and none. These are all eight words. If you don't find the mention of any kinds of these five words at the beginning of the sentence, then you think that the structure should follow the third structure and that is another particular structure. In that day, actually, we discussed very well about two rules. So, before going to the evaluation test, now we need to discuss the third rule from the structure. Okay, boys? The third structure is the common structure we learned was if you don't find the use of anybody, anyone, everybody, everyone, everyone, or nobody, no one, none. Then, we will think in an observer, the sentence is on the basis of number three. And what is the structure of number three? Then, yes. Look here. This structure is no need to use the next question. Here, only we use the proof when we find it in the next A sentence is given to you to turn the sentence in its interpretive form. If we don't find the use or mention in the word, okay. Boys, if we don't find the mention in the word, if we don't find the mention in the word, not in the sentence itself, at that case, we will have to use not. But if we find the use of not or any negation of just into the sentence, at that time we will use it. Okay, boys. Again, I'm saying, suppose the sentence is given to you and you ask to change the sentence in its interpretive form. So, at that case, you will use not or not use not. I am removing the doubt of you about using not. If we don't find the mention of not or negation of in the sentence itself, if we don't find, okay, only then at the time we are allowed to use it. But if we find the mentioning of not or any kind of negation words in the sentence, at that time, we must not use that. That means we are not allowed to use that at that time. And that's why I have used here bracket, not within bracket. Understood, boys? So it is not mandatory to use not. Boys, I think you are understood now. The simple thing that if you find use of not in the sentence, at that time you will use not. But if you don't find use of not in the sentence, only then you will have to use the not over structures. Okay, I'm giving the example. After discussing this three rules of three structures, we will go through a test or evaluation.
He did have it.
He is a voice. Look, this is the sentence.
If I ask you, right? What is the structure? Structure number 1 or 2 or 3? What is the structure of this structure?
So, he will say, sir, here only the third structure should be applicable, because in the first structure we know if we find anybody, anyone, everyone, and all, At that time, O will have to use the first structure. But if and if we find age of no lung, nobody known lung, at that stage, O are allowed to use the second structure. And when we must find that when we mentioning of any kinds of any words of the about eight discussed or prescribed words, at that time we are allowed to use the structure number three. So look here, guys. Here at the beginning of the word, we are not finding the use of. We are not finding the use of. Everybody enjoying it, or nobody know and know, etc. That's why the third structure should be applicable here. Okay, boys? The third structure. So, how do you look? Here, but in the sentence, we are not finding that in the auxiliary. So, in the sentence, there is no auxiliary. So we are now in that, because if we want to make a sentence in its included form, at that time, of course, we need the use of auxiliary. But this is a sentence from the tense, present indefinite tense, and we know in present indefinite tense, there is no use of auxiliary. So now we are going to remove this, to get rid from this gender. Now we will have to go to the outside of auxiliary form. And what are the outside of auxiliaries? We know do, does, or did. These are three outside of auxiliaries which are usually used in the question of making which is negative or infinitive. So here we are dependent on the outside of auxiliary and group like that, because this is the sentence from present indefinite tense. And we know, in case of present indefinite tense, do and does make them for the as. As at the look wise, here the meaning of the statement, we are even watching that as or is has been added just after the name. So, now we are allowed to use does, not we are allowed to use do does, because the subject here is the person and singular number. So does. Okay, boys. After writing does, according to the structure here, we will use the subject. What is the subject? The subject is he. So I am a he. After writing the subject he, we will have to use. We will try to use now. If you ask why is it? Can I be able to use not here? Of course, you will say yes. You are allowed to use not here, because there is no mention of not in the sentence itself. So we will use does he. Yes, but one thing was, do you know why it is not? Why? Because we are not allowed to change the meaning between the answer and the questions. The meaning that we will find from the first sentence, that means from the question, of course, in our answer, that meaning should remain in the if the meaning between this answer and the questions, okay, if you find the difference between the answer and the question, then our answer would be correct. Because in the summation sentence, we will change the sentence but keep the same meaning in the question which we find in the questions. Otherwise, so, and that's why for keeping the same meaning, we use not. So, does he not? After using not, we use the main word. What is the main word there? This. So, I am writing here. But for this, eliminate S.
Yes, that has been added. After the main completes, we will have to eliminate that S of H because we have already used that. That's why, again, S will be added after the main part.
So, does the complete and in the rest part of the sentence. Next level is with you.
And no other conditions. Because now I am writing the second example. Look here, the second example that I have written is Bolivia is a poor farmer. Bolivia is a poor farmer. Look here. This is one kind of assertive sentence, also affirmative sentence. We are finding no use or no mention of those eight words. Okay? What are they? Everybody applaud, everybody know who are, and nobody knows them. These are the eight words. And we are not finding any one of these eight words at the beginning of the sentence. So, this sentence is on the basis of power. That means, here we have to follow the structure number three. So, according to the structure number three, we are allowed to know the of the real voice here is. So, is it actually called auxiliary? So, it is here, it has been used here as for auxiliary voice in the main. Okay? So, we have to use this. Okay? Is. What is that? After that, it, that is auxiliary. So-called auxiliary is, auxiliary is. Now, we will use the subject. And what is the subject?
Bolivia.
Okay. Okay, right. Is Bolivia. Then, the charge of closing. Are we allowed in here for this one? But it has close. Of course, we are allowed to use not here because in that question we are not finding the question we are. As there is no use of man not in that question, so the answer we must use. So, is coming in now. The voice. And then we will give the main part. But look here. Is has been used as principal and also main. So there is no rest, there is no another main part. So when there is no main part, in that case we will not use the main part. That is why here I am also giving at the bottom. So if you find the main part, then we will use. If you don't find the main part, so even we are not finding the main part because there is no main part. Okay? Is itself auxiliary or personal main part? Is already has been used already. That's why. In second time, for the second time, we will not use. However, leaving this part now, we have to use the object. So, this object is a four part. Okay, my mirror is look. That service. Is Bolivia not a poor farmer? You can also write, is not Bolivia a poor farmer? If, but if you use now, just after the auxiliary, at that time, you will have to use the contracted form. And that is isn't. Not is not. you should write isn't, not does not, doesn't. Okay, boys. Now I am writing another topic. Okay. I am erasing the board. Dear students, look, the example number 3 here is, he did the work of his own effort. And we are asked here to change this sentence into its interpretive form. How we can do it? How we can do it? Okay, boys. Look, what is the beginning of? Nobody knows who, everybody knows, everybody knows who. This is a date, but there is no any one out of this age here at the beginning. So, this rule is on the basis of the structure number 3. So, according to the structure number 3, first of all, we are allowed to use. We are allowed to use auxiliary. But, my boys, we are crossing here that there is no auxiliary. There is no mention of no use of any auxiliary. M is a auxiliary, shall be, has a, can be, may, might, must, it, have, to, has to, have to, is going, are going to, is to, are to, was to, ought to. Okay, boys, look here. This sort of auxiliaries are missing here. So, in the sentence, we are not finding the use of auxiliary. At this case, we will have to borrow the object from the outside of the sentence. And we know that very well who counts at the period of gender, especially when we do not find any children. Actually, then who does it will come or after. If the sentence is your present tense, then and do or does should be hired from outside of the sentence. But if the sentence is a past tense, at that moment we will have the date from the outside of the sentence. So in the sentence we are looking at did has been written down. That means it is within the main verb here and it is the past form of the main verb. So as the sentence, so this represents this scenario represents before us that sentence is in the form of past tense. So we are allowed to use did from the outside, not the self-did that has been used in the sentence itself. Now we have did from the outside of the sentence, right? Because it is a past tense. So did. This did has not been used yet. Rather, I have borrowed did from the outside of the sentence, as there is no meaning to come to that. So did I have used it here? I have used it here. Did then subject. What is the subject? After doing the subject, what will we have to do? We will try to use not. There is no use of not, so it is. Otherwise, so did we not. After writing the subject, we try to use the main form. So, what is the main term here? This is the D. Right? This D is that. Right? So now, we are allowed to use it because past form, past tense has already been in the beginning. So now we will use the present form. These have did. So what is the present form of it? I'm in do. So class is now do. Class is now do. And then the rest of the part of the sentence should be written down in total form. And that is the work of this. Okay, actually, this is all on the basis of rule number 3 and section number 3. So, I'm taking a calibration. There are three rules, or three structures of the question of sentence. Now we are to the structure of learning rule number 3 or structure number 3. And here, we have learned that if we don't find any more, any words of the eight words, eight words, and there, everybody of them, anybody and everyone, again, nobody knows nothing. If we don't find any one is any of the eight words in the beginning of the sentence, at that case, we understand that the sentence is on the basis of the rule number 3. Okay? So, here, the examples that we have learned. We see that there is no use of any kind of this words, the thing that it works. That's why the third structure and third rule. Okay, guys. I think now you all have understood. So, see you again in the next class. We will together go through the last class. Okay, guys. Today, it is impossible for me. It has been impossible for me to discuss and go through the last class in my next class. We will go through the next class and the last class. And we will try to understand understanding from this discussion. So, first, thank you, Mr. Bye, boys. Thank you.